On the internet, I've been hearing about new potential Our Lady of Medjugorje apparitions from the summer of 2024. I don't know how valid those posts are, of course, but I was wondering if the church came out with any official statements about these events being supernatural or not. And the follow-up would be, if the church has not come out with the position, what is yours?
Okay, so I don't have a personal position on this, but I can tell you the history of what's happened with Medjugorje. The initial bishop looked into the apparitions being reported in his diocese, and he ruled that they couldn't be considered supernatural. His successor then looked into them as well, and he ruled the same thing. Then the Yugoslavian Bishops' Conference looked into them, and they concluded the same thing. Then, during the tenure of Pope Benedict the 16th, he appointed the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith to look into this question, and they appointed a commission to study them more closely. And the results of that commission have not yet been released. So the current, as things stand, position is negative towards this being supernatural. Now, the Vatican then, of just a few months ago in May, issued a new set of guidelines for evaluating apparitions, and it has seven categories, with supernatural at the top, not supernatural at the bottom, and then a spectrum of other categories in between that reflect different degrees of confidence and problems that can pertain to an apparition. Thus far, they haven't made a ruling on Medjugorje. They probably will do so, because they've really been cranking. They've like already ruled on six different apparitions. And obviously, people who want to know about Medjugorje are a large number. And frankly, it looks like the new categories were designed to fit Medjugorje. In particular, one of the middle categories that it's like, okay, we're not saying this is supernatural and there are significant problems here, looks like it was really specifically designed for Medjugorje. Having said that, Cardinal Fernandez, the head of the doctrine, dicastery for the Doctrine of the Faith, was asked about Medjugorje, and he said he hadn't yet had a chance to review the report, but they could look at it, and I think he said would be looking at it in terms of the new guidelines. And he didn't commit to which category they were going to put it in. The highest category that doesn't involve the Pope now is the second category. Under supernatural, there's a category called nihil obstat, which means we're not saying it's supernatural, but nothing obstructs. That's what nihil obstat means. Nothing obstructs the faithful from being able to participate in this in a healthy way. And when he was asked about Medjugorje, he mentioned, that it could go in a number of different categories. And he even mentioned the possibility of a nihil obstat, provided that certain clarifications could be issued to clarify otherwise problematic statements. And this is something you see them doing in the recent approvals they've given, where they'll say, okay, we're giving a nihil obstat to this, but you need to understand it in this way to avoid some theological errors. And so we held up the hypothetical possibility that a nihil obstat could be given to Medjugorje, but he didn't commit to that. He said, I haven't looked at the documents yet. I haven't studied it yet. So this was all speculation. And frankly, some of the other lower categories seem to fit Medjugorje better. I suspect, because of how quickly they've been cranking through these things, that we will get a ruling on Medjugorje before too long. I suspect it won't be immediate because of the care they need to take in this case. And if I made a prediction, I would predict that they probably won't give it a nihil obstat, given some of the factors that are involved, but we'll have to wait and see.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this Catholic Answer, be sure to like, subscribe, and check out our live streams Monday through Friday, 3 to 5 p.m. Pacific. Or find the episode after on YouTube, your favorite podcast platform, or our Catholic Answers app.